Hello guys, welcome to a new video, and today we have another car. This one is very yellow compared to my car. It's Jeff's E36. He's here to film his car. So what we have here is a E36 323i, so same as me, but a little bit different compared to mine. So I think we're gonna start on the outside because that's the dead giveaway that this car isn't stock anymore. So as we walk around to the front, we got the rear lip with the canards in carbon, so that's pretty nice, that's pretty neat. And the hood fans, so this is to release pressure, right?
Yeah, also some heating from the car.
Yeah, so the hot air can escape.
Yeah, especially when I'm standing still after a lap or something. It's, yeah, you see the heat coming off.
Yeah, so. And same with the hood, why it's a little bit, so that's all the...
Because when you drive, you have a vacuum in the inside the engine compartment, and to release the air, just flow over the car.
It's a pretty neat solution.
Yeah,
I haven't seen that much before, but
no, they do it a lot in JDM, Honda guys, but I thought, I was looking why they did it, and the history about it is just because of the release of the air in the pocket, and some heating.
Yeah, makes sense. So also the canards, that's just to widen the track.
Yeah, wider wheels. The fender flares.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's to widen the track. It was also an issue with the E36 stuff, rust. So, good. First, I had some wider arches.
Oh, even wider than?
Even wider, yeah, a lot wider. Just running some spacers and didn't like it. Then I was at the Nürburgring, saw all the clean E36s. I was thinking, I'm regretting this. Yeah. So,
have to go back to smaller ones.
Smaller ones. Just do the smaller ones back to
so
no spacers at
the
all.
Width on the front and the rear is the same?
No, it's staggered.
Oh yeah.
It's staggered. Front is 8.5.
Oh yes. Yeah.
By 13.
Yeah.
And the back is 9.5 and 22.
Yeah, so it's impossible to fit a 9.5 on a stock body E36.
Yeah, also with the it's possible, but then you have to go with the offset a lot more higher.
Yeah.
And this is like 22.
Oh yeah, so this is pretty
very
normal.
Low.
Yeah. And then your new addition,
yeah,
the GT wing.
Yeah, from French Power.
So it's the one piece.
Yeah.
Very strong compared to the four piece.
Indeed.
This is fiberglass?
Yeah,
fiberglass,
indeed. And yeah, the guys from Nürburgring, I had some contact with them and they said, yeah, it's very good. So
yeah,
I tried it.
It's,
and the fitment was spot on.
Yeah, that's the really positive thing about these wings is that you don't have to fuck around with the stupid fitmer from the riser.
Yes.
Because a riser is always a problem.
Especially because it's...
Yeah, it's always
aftermarket.
Yeah, especially.
Yours
and fiberglass is always a bit off. Then on the rear we have a diffuser.
Custom made
diffuser.
Yeah, with the Bostock exhaust.
It's a bit hidden in here. So that pretty much covers the outside of the car. Let's go more into in depth, especially the suspension.
Yeah, it's running KWs.
KW, yeah.
Version 2s.
I don't know if you can see it. Yeah.
With camber plates in the front, camber arms at the rear.
Oh, camber arms in the rear as well, yeah.
Yeah, camber arms at the rear. Everything is in PU.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
So,
yeah. Great addition.
Also, the eccentric pillar balls at the front. So, it's a bit.
Oh, yeah, that, I don't have that, but a lot of people tell me that's a really good mod to do.
Yeah, because your arms are a little bit to the front.
Yeah.
So your wheel is a little bit to the front too. And when you're braking, it settles zich...
It settles better.
It settles better.
Yeah.
The suspension is going from a degree to straighten up.
Yeah. And brakes.
It's
big brakes. Yeah. If you see them fitment on the wheels.
It's
very tight.
That was a fun story because, yeah, they said 330 E46 brakes will fit on a 17 inch, but you need to have a wide 17 inch. So I was putting them on, and a friend of mine said, "Yeah, will it fit?" I was very confident. Yeah. But in the back of my head, I was thinking, "I hope so."
Yeah. Started sweating.
and then put the wheel on, and the weight of the wheel hit the.
Oh, so you had to move them so to make to fit the brake.
No, every time I change tires,
yeah,
I have like 10 kilometers that the
they're rubbing a little.
Hit my brake caliper.
And then it's over. Oh, that's pretty funny.
Yeah.
So Brembo discs.
Yeah, Brembo Sport Max.
Yeah, you can see that on the pattern on the discs. And then Brembo pads as well.
Yeah,
just normal pads.
Normal pads, because yeah, it's working for me.
Yeah. Braided lines as well, right?
Hmm?
Braided lines.
Yeah, braided lines from Goodrich.
Yes.
And also the normal braking fluid. Not even.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know why, but I don't need it.
Yeah, if it's working.
For now.
Yeah.
For now, and it's running on Federal RSRs.
Yeah. So. Little bit of a starting semi-slick.
Yeah,
ultra performance tire. Yeah, ultra performance tire or ultra high performance tire.
Ultra high performance tire, something like that.
So is it technically a semi slick or is it?
They said it's a UHP because it's a semi slick has even less tread on it and will be more sketchy in the rain and here in Holland.
Yeah, it's raining
a lot.
So it's a good choice.
Yeah, I think it's okay. This morning I was checking the alignment.
Yeah.
And then it rained, and my brother was riding my car back, and it have a spare.
Oh, you have a LSD as well.
LSD as well. Yeah.
Oh, that's a good mod. Yeah.
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 Very good mod. You notice really the difference between
open
and LSD.
And, this is a 323i, so stock is like 2.93 ratio.
Yeah.
And this is
3.15.
Yeah, so better acceleration.
Yeah, indeed.
Do you feel it a lot? Shorter ratio?
The first time I had from 293 to 315.
Yeah.
I noticed a very big difference. But I went from 315 even shorter to 3.45.
Yeah.
And now from 3.45 back to 315.
Oh, and then you notice...
I notice a little bit slow.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's okay. It's okay.
Then move on to the interior or what's left of it. So, the big thing is the red full cage. Look at that. Door bars. Very nice. And on the roof... cross at the rear, harness bar as well. So was it your intention to build a race car or
no? First it was static, low.
Oh yeah, stance guy.
After that I pulled out the rear seat because we were going to a street race and
needed the extra speed.
Yeah. And I noticed it was a very big difference.
That's when it got out of hand.
Yep.
So we got bucket seat, QSP.
Big ones.
How do you like them?
Huh?
Do you like the seats?
Yeah, I like them because...
Are they comfortable? Or are they comfortable?
For me it's okay.
It's enough, yeah. It's
okay.
It's a race car.
it's a race car.
But you can drive it to the ring 3 hours and be fine.
Yes.
Oh yeah, that's good.
Before this ones, I had some old Cobra buckets. They were pain in the ass.
Yeah.
And now this ones, I really like it. Really like it. The only thing, my girlfriend also drives this car. Also on the Nordschleife or other tracks. And so we had a, how do you call it in English?
Slider?
Slider, yeah, thanks. For the driver's seat, but also I need also one for the passenger seat. So that's a thing that I have to change.
Yeah.
Before we go and we are going to the Nürburgring again, because it's very tight for me. So yeah.
So also, do you have a short shifter?
Yeah, chassis mounted since last week.
Oh, nice. That's a good change.
Yeah, I really love it.
And then we got these light door panels, light steering wheel, basically. All of this removed, and then on the rear, just taken everything out to save the most amount of weight and to get some extra nice noises.
Yeah, a lot of too many noises.
Yeah,
I have to put a plate, a firewall plate in it.
Is it that loud?
Yeah,
too crazy.
Too crazy. I'm sitting after 1 hour, here because of the vibration of the sound.
Oh yeah.
Reflects to the window, and then my left ear.
It's just
after 3 hours.
And so for the exhaust, it's like, is it straight piped or?
Yeah.
Basically.
Basically.
No cats, no mufflers.
No. Only the back muffler.
Yeah.
And so
then,
it's.
Other headers as well.
Yeah, okay,
the Schmidt mount.
Was
the engine?
Yeah, of course.
So M52.
M52 with M50 headers.
Oh, yeah. So you got the manifold. And then, oh, here are the headers. So did you notice a big difference in power and sound from the headers?
Yeah,
yeah.
A lot.
But did you do the headers first and then Kettlers or everything at once?
We did the headers.
Yeah.
And it had the cats and the mid mufflers,
yeah,
and we were looking at my exhaust and we said, I said, only delete the muffler, okay, and he cut it also the cats of it, so
just
it's
everything gone,
okay. So since then it's straight piped,
yeah.
Bust Schmidtmann headers, Bostock exhaust, sounds amazing,
yeah.
Yeah, pretty much.
It's pretty much the basics.
Yeah.
Intake, exhaust,
tune.
Yeah.
Also tune. Also the electric fan.
Oh yeah, yeah. That's a good thing. Yeah, these cars
I really
get a little
it.
Hot.
Yeah. Don't notice it because of the a lot of cooling.
Yeah.
So it's really nice.
Yeah.
It's a great car. I really love to drive it. Don't do that as much as I want, but
yeah, I can imagine this thing is fun to drive.
Hmm?
I can imagine this is fun to drive.
Yeah, really fun, but on the open roads.
Yeah, it's not that fun as the track.
No, it's really built for track.
Yeah.
And here in Holland, rain.
Yeah, not the ideal conditions.
No, because of the alignment is also for track.
Yeah.
And then.
You also don't want to wear out your tires on the streets.
No, I don't.
You've been driving on these tires for 2 years now?
2 years, yeah. 2 seasons now. Yeah. But I don't drive that much because we have also another car next to it, of course. And
yeah,
my working place is like 4 kilometers from my house.
So this is the track tool for the weekend.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Should we take it for a drive?
Of course.
Let's go.
Thank you.
So that was the drive with Jeff's E36. I must say it was rowdy compared to my car. So yeah, that's a positive thing. And also the exhaust was such a big difference compared to my car. It's so much louder, and of course the pops and bangs. That's even next level. But the exhaust, like after 3000 RPM, it started screaming, just rasping, and that's something I'm missing on my car greatly. So that's something we need to get fixed. But don't worry, I got something planned. But yeah, I want to thank Jeff for taking his car out.
Of course, of course.
Because yeah, that makes these videos possible, and that's it's always fun to show other people's cars. So
I like to show it.
Yeah, that's why.
I'm not. Yeah, also on Instagram, of course. But
you can follow him on Instagram. I'm gonna put the tag in the video, and I'm gonna put it in the description below, so you can follow more on his build. Then
thank you guys for watching the video. Please like, comment, subscribe. Let me know what you think of Jeff's car. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.